our record is like this blend, I see it as a blend of dance music and R&B, and that Other People Place record is, you know, this blend of kind of house and electro funk. So we saw it as a good reference point. The record that I think influenced my album the most would be Lifestyles of the Laptop Café by the Other People Place. A good friend of mine played me a track off of the record called Moonlight Rendezvous. She was just like, I think you'll really like this. And just from that track, I just kind of became obsessed with, I mean, I got a hold of the record. It's one of those records that like is incredibly hard to find on vinyl. Like I think people pay like hundreds of dollars to get a hold of it. So I don't have it on vinyl, but I like downloaded it off iTunes, and I just, from that track, Moonlight Rendezvous, I just explored the rest of it and loved the whole thing. There were other records that I definitely listened to obsessively, like while we were making the album, but I think the reason I picked this one is because it's like a Detroit electro record, and it obviously is influenced by techno, but it's not quite techno, and it's obviously influenced a lot by like by funk music too, like by like Parliament has a little bit of like R&B in it, which also influences like a lot of the music that I really love, like Boogie or like Patrice Rushen or like Melba Moore, like Kashif and that scene as well. And like Jer comes from a much more dance-based background than I do. Like techno and house music is something that he's been like DJing since he was 16, and I come from a much more R&B place, and so the record kind of sits in this like, it's not quite dance music and it's not quite mainstream R&B. And then I saw this Lifestyles of the Laptop Café as kind of being a record similar to that, where it's not quite techno. It's obviously informed by techno, but it also has these funk influences too, and it kind of sits in this weird place where it's not quite techno, but it has all these like funk R&B influences that we kind of, it's really similar to the record that we made. Before I started working on this record, I went to school for jazz music, and I was like really well versed in like, you know, learning standards, and my approach to songwriting was like sitting at the piano and like trying to write chords and lyrics, and I think it's really hard to write songs that way. And when I started experimenting with these different synths that I had collected, I realized that, you know, you could like base a song off of a texture or a sound, and that's something in the Other People Place record that like it's so simple. Some of the tracks, like that Moonlight Rendezvous one that I mentioned, is just this like bassline riff. It's like this real kind of like funk riff that just goes through the whole thing, and it just never really changes. And this couple synth lines that go against it, and it's such a simple song, but it's just so incredible. And I just realized that, you know, you don't have to have these really standard structures to songs. You can just really base it around the textures more so than verse, pre-chorus, chorus record. So the simplicity of that record really influenced my writing when it came to Pull My Hair Back.